Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So another Azur lane video. Let's start. Okay. So, still the same as yesterday. Still trying to get Atago. And I did 10 ship building yesterday. Let's see if one of these are going to be super rare. Hopefully. Yesterday, no super rare at all, which is kind of sucks. So, supposed to be today, I'm going to get like at least one super rare if it's based on the 7% percentage. So, let's open the first one. Deploy! Tennessee, okay. I don't have her yet. That's nice. The second one. Give me. Oh. My fourth? I think my fourth empire. One of the new event unit. Repulse. Fourth? Fantasy again. Okay, the fifth one. Super rare, please. Whoa, okay. Well, I already have her from the daily login, so limit break. That's nice. Prince Eugene. Well, at least a super rare today. The sixth will. Nevada again. Seventh. Give me super rare. Pensacola. Eight. Portland. 9th. Northampton. Okay, the last one. Finish now. Edinburgh. Okay, I don't have her yet, so that's nice. Okay, one super rare, and it is Prince Eugene. Well, actually, it is about the time to limit break her because she's already level 70 in my account. I'm not going to use my bullion for her, I think. So, here we go. I don't have enough coin, okay. Yeah, so forget about the limit break for a moment until I can get my Atago. So yeah, this is my latest formation to farm this Atago, by the way. Yeah, I changed my Enterprise into Akagi because of my Enterprise already level 100. And actually, the Fleet 2 have one cost lower than the Fleet 1. The Fleet 1 is 22, the Fleet 2 is only 21. And yeah, I'm farming this while leveling up my character, so it is okay to have a little bit more oil cost, but I can raise the characters I want while doing this kind of quest. Okay. So usually I beat 5 normal fleets using this fleet. Yeah, 5 normal enemy. And then I beat the boss using Javelin, Akagi and Hood fleet. Yeah, this squad's damage is already quite decent, even though I still have a lot of low level characters in this fleet. So yeah, I think the difficulty is kinda makes sense for new players. Maybe when you have level 30, 40 ships, you can start to grind here. Yeah, maybe at least level 40. Bam. So in total, I have to do 5 enemies, right? 22 5 times means 110, and then 21 from the second fleet, 131, in total 141 oil needed in one run if it's based on my fleet. Still not bad. Yeah, I'm doing this while raising my character's level, so it is okay. Yeah, Yeah, they are much stronger than yesterday, actually. Yesterday was like, you know, that Cleveland died too early and stuff. This time, she's much stronger. And Luffy is very good. A very good starter. Okay. Oreo janai. Oriku da yo. That's really funny. I'm not Oreo, I'm Olik. My Olik is almost level 70, by the way. Oh! I don't like this. So let's switch to the other fleet. That's just going to waste another 22 oil if I fight that ambush fleet. So yeah, this is the second fleet, only 21 oil cost. My Hood is still low level. Yeah, she's still kinda weak. Okay. But my javelin is strong enough. One javelin is enough. Look at the damage. Already pretty good. Go Hood! Hood's damage is still not that high. Okay. 21 oil cost. 3 ships only. My javelin is almost level 90. And I don't have enough gold to limit break the things. It just kinda sucks. Oh, I need gold. I need more coins. So in the end, I can do around 10 to 12 ship building every day on the even limited building things. Okay. Javelin is unexpectedly very strong for a starter unit. Yeah, I chose her in the beginning. It was like, I choose you, Javelin! Pikachu! Just kidding. Okay, is that the last one? Probably yes. Okay, that main fleet is so tough. But it's the end. Okay, level 90. Wow, I really need gold. But I don't want to buy gold using gem. That just seems so wrong. Okay, the last normal fleet fight, I think. And after this, I can start to fight the boss. Actually, this map is kinda easier than chapter 3-4. I mean, with the same fleet, Akagi, Hood, and Javelin like this, I took more damage on the chapter 3-4, the place to farm Akagi and Kaga. But here, yeah, they didn't take that many damage compared to chapter 3-4. A little bit more. 1383, that's my javelin's torpedo damage. Okay, the boss now. Okay, super rare. Come please. Still no Prince of Wales drop until today. Wow. You know, a friend of mine did this quest twice. A real life friend, did this quest twice and then he already got his Prince of Wales. What the? So lucky, man. Okay. There you go, Atago. Torpedo, torpedo, torpedo incoming! Javelin! Oh, only hit one. That's kinda annoying, the AI, the auto battle. Sometimes using the torpedo, like on the bottom part of the map, like what the? Good? Okay, so please, Super Rare. Super Rare, Prince of Wales Punch! Ah! Okay, before I end this video, I think I can try an arena exercise. I think I will try to fight this one. I think, yeah, I'm losing the Vanguard power, but the main power, mine, is much higher, so I'm still kinda think that I can win this. Okay. Whoa, infinite darkness. Erebus. Or terror. Okay, one Vanguard left and one main fleet left. Enterprise is just so strong, man. The same Prince Eugene. Using the skill at exactly the same time. Oh, Warida! It's over now! Okay. And as usual, Enterprise is the MVP. Wow, the damage difference is real, man. I think this is like the real definition of OP. Look at the damage. Okay. So I think that's all for today's video. Tomorrow I will try to build some more ships. Yeah, still trying to get my Atago. Can I have enough? Oh, okay. One more ship building in this video. So it will be like 11 ship building. Atago punch! Atago? Not going to be Atago though. Shropshire. Okay. That's a quite bad result. Okay, but today at least I got a Prince Eugene. A Super Rare. Not that. So yeah, I think that's all for now guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe now if you haven't. And see you again next time. Bye bye. Azur Lane. Global Punch.